Thank you. stand armed.
You're 19 or 20 or 21, you know that, you believe that you're invincible.
We had been warned quite extensively that we would suffer some pretty horrendous casualties.
When we got ready for the D-Day, we were given photographs of where we would land.
We were getting on ship, and I was here, and he was way down farther, but I saw him, and I waved at him, and he waved back, and he said, "Goodbye, John." And he's the first guy I saw dead on the beach.
And we then got to the point you didn't give a darn where you were. You just wanted to get on shore, get off this thing.
He could see them looking down, that they were dropping their gliders right in across the enemy lines, and of course, he just mowing them down.
A D-Day, we landed right in the middle of the enemy. When I was coming down with a chute, I could hear the guns going off.
They weren't interested in us as much as they were the ships that were behind us, the big ones. That's what they wanted.
And the first landing, wham. I looked in here, the ship broke right in two, and the whole stern end of it, right straight up.
If they didn't get off, you pushed them off. And I didn't have to do it, those fellows up front had to, or their own people had to. It's kind of sad. And a lot of them never made it to the beach.
Some of the water was too deep. The guys just went under, they couldn't come up.
But as soon as they found out that we were on the beach, they started shelling us. So we moved pretty fast.
So those flail tanks finally got in, and you got those flails going, and they were blowing mines up by the thousands all over the beach, and that was clearing room for us to get in.
The Germans had a big barricade up there, they had a bulkhead, and they had a machine gun, they had a bunker. And as soon as they'd come off the beach, they could pick them off and slaughter them.
Then when we turned to go in, I was near Bishop Carney, my friend. Let's kill them.
But there was wounded everywhere and screaming and hollering and people in the water floating and
when you're dying, at least these guys were dying, that's what they said. You know, mama, mama.
You depend on each other, and if that dependency wasn't there, you'd be hopelessly lost right from the start.
We had not one patient, 1,200 empty beds with hot water bottles in them. After I spoke with this man, I looked out the window. You could not see the end of the ambulances. Every bed was filled, 1,200 beds. Isn't that something?
Isn't that a terrible thing to hold somebody in your arms? You know, when he's dying?
I can never go to bed at night before thinking the guys who died. They're the one who saved my life. They're the one who won the war, not me. It's them. To give their life for the country, simple as that.
Thank you. Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb 4 days. Now that day was near Jerusalem, some 2 miles away. Many Jews had come to Martha and Mary to console them about their brother. Martha heard that Jesus was coming. She went and met him, for Mary stayed at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that God will give you whatever you ask him in answer." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise again." Martha said to him, "I know that he will rise again in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to me, "Yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one coming into the world." Jesus was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid me?" They said to him, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated.
Jesus makes his way to see his good friend Lazarus, who has died. However, he takes his time in arriving at Bethany. When he meets Lazarus' sisters, Mary and Martha, when he approaches the tomb, and when he finally meets his good friend on his deathbed, we cannot help but picture Jesus overwhelmed with grief, sorrow, and anguish. So much so that the Gospel says this simple line, "Jesus wept." We forget that our Lord is both human and divine, and that he suffered the same way any of us have suffered, including when it comes to a loved one. If he was able to weep for someone so close to him, if he was willing to die for everyone else, what more is it that we must weep for those who have offered their lives for us? Both people who we may know and are giving sacrifices, but also those who we may not know who have offered their lives for our freedoms.
Our constellation chamber of art will send you home, written by the Mount Sinai Murray and Mark Murray. It was written when the MS member lost her cousin driving to the suicide. The song was recorded by the MS sisters, Maureen, Teresa, and Kevin, in collaboration with the Shadow of Glory. They also performed the song 2 years ago at a special commemoration ceremony on June 8th.
Thank you.
beloved month of the 11th day to the 11th hour is a time where we remember those who have suffered and sacrificed their lives for us so we can have a better today. May we remember that when we weep, we don't weep alone. We now invite you to watch and listen to our senior drawing class pay tribute to those who have great work and those who have and continue to live their lives alone. From our earlier gospel reading, we have John 11:35, one of the shortest verses in the Bible. In the King James Version, it is simply, Jesus wept.
To those who chose to be so great, to those who rest within the grave, to the ones who fell and did not rise with bayonets in hand and fury in eyes, to those who lay on planted fields, to those blanketed in poppy seeds, to the trench shooters, barbed wire archers, and front foot chargers, to the privates, lieutenants, and camp dead war tanks, to the ones who didn't make it back alive.
May they go, John 11:35.
To those fighting at sea, sand, or land, to those who see war at first hand, to the Normandy landers, to the beach stormers and cliff climbers, to those who lived at the sword and died at the sword, to the war zone controllers and fresh-faced enrollers, to the heat-seeking missile controllers, to the every generation of soldiers, may their hearts bind.
To two words from John 11:35.
To those who battle back home, to those isolated and alone, to those who grieve and no loss of sleep, to those who pain and cut so deep, to those who know the ache of loss, to those who pay such a loss, to those who know the loss of their soulmate, to the ones who not yet know their fate, to the thinkers, feelers, and mind blockers, to the bedridden, rage-driven, to the unforgiving and unforgiven, to those who was long left behind, may they know John 11:35.
To those who fight for what is right, to those who long to reunite, to those who know their time is close, to those who know that pain the most.
Thank you. Thank you. blood, he gave his body to pay for our sins. We remember his sacrifice for us, and we remember that while we were still sinners, he gave his life for us. We remember his grace and the love and the moment that he changed our lives forever. And it seems fitting that during this time of national remembrance, that we thank God for not only his son, Jesus, but also for those men who gave their last full measure of devotion for our country, allowing us to enjoy and appreciate the freedom they won and protected for us. Freedom to worship, to pray, and to offer witness. His love of Christ, love, and to practice our faith. Let us not take that freedom for granted. Today, with grateful hearts, let us pray. Let us practice our faith. Let us not take that freedom for granted. Let us love and practice our faith in a manner worthy of the ultimate sacrifice that so many of our nation's finest and best gave have given over the years. We are free. And today, we are thankful. And we remember.
Almighty Everlasting God, we offer our prayers and gratitude for those who died in defending this country and freedom. Grant them eternal rest and peace to us who keep faith in them, that we may be instruments of reconciliation and peace, following the example of your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We will now pause as our cadets exit.
Guard, freeze them, arm. Float, arm. Fall, out. Guard, by that last quick march.
Those of you close to the weight room, please exit.